So now we're going to look at interdomain routing business models. So the one thing to remember about interdomain routing is that it's really all about routing money. Let's consider this AS that wants to send traffic to a particular destination. Well, in the internet, there are two different types of business relationships. A customer-provider business relationship, where money flows from customer to provider, regardless of the direction that traffic flows. The other type of business relationship is a peering relationship, where an AS can exchange traffic with another AS free of charge. This is sometimes also called settlement-free peering. So already you can see, given three possible ways to reach the destination, this AS is first going to prefer a route through its customer, because regardless of the direction of traffic on this link, money is always flowing from the customer. The peering link is second most preferable because it's free, and the least preferable route is through the provider, because the AS has to pay money every time it sends traffic on this link. This leads to the basic rules of preference in interdomain routing, where customer routes are preferred over peer routes, which are in turn preferred over provider routes. The other consideration that an AS has to make is filtering or export decisions. In other words, given that an AS learns a route from its neighbor, to whom should it re-advertise that route? To understand filtering and export decisions, let's add a couple more ASs to the graph. Let's add another peer, and let's add another provider. Let's call this AS in the middle of the picture Cox Communications. This ISP might have smaller regional customers, and it might also buy transit connectivity from other providers. Now let's suppose that this AS learns routes to a destination via its customer, its peer, and its provider. Now we already have established that it would prefer the customer route so that it can make money by sending traffic to that destination. But what about filtering decisions? Well, routes that are learned from a customer, Cox, of course, would want to re-advertise to everyone else, because the more people use that route, the more money Cox makes. Therefore, a route that's learned from a customer gets advertised to everybody else. On the other hand, a route that's learned from a provider, if it were actually selected, would of course only be advertised to customers. It wouldn't make any sense to take a route like this and advertise it to another provider. The reason, of course, is that money is flowing in the direction of the providers. So any route that's learned from a provider would never be advertised to another provider, because it would result in Cox essentially becoming a transit provider between two of its own providers and paying them both for the privilege of carrying that traffic. So routes learned from a provider would only ever be advertised to other customers. And similarly, routes from peers would only be advertised to other customers, not to other peers or other providers. So to summarize, interdomain routing has both ranking rules, where given multiple choices, an AS might prefer a customer route over a peer route over a provider route. And then, given that it's selected a particular route from either a customer, a provider, or a peer, it makes different decisions about where to re-advertise that route to other neighboring ASs. Now, as it turns out, if every AS in the internet followed these rules exactly, then routing stability is guaranteed. Now, you might wonder, isn't routing stability guaranteed already? And it turns out that it isn't.